So we have a question here about how you can replace an alias domain with a secondary domain that also already has several email addresses. Are you going to lose data adding a new domain as a secondary domain? Now, there's a little bit of an intricacy to get this right, to make sure that you actually don't kind of mess this up, to add a secondary domain. Basically, if right now you have two domains in Workspace and you've got them both configured to receive email, but you want to change one from an alias to a secondary domain, there's a little bit of a process to make that happen. So I'm going to draw this one out with you just to make sure that we all get on the same page and we all understand how this works. So I've got my trusty little Jamboard here. And so I'm going to draw out our different domains here. So let's say one domain is .com and we have another domain which is .com.au. So that's if you're in Australia, you're going to have .com and you're going to have .com.au. Now, when we have an alias domain, you're always going to have a primary domain in your Google Workspace account, right? That primary domain is like the one that you're signed up with Google. And so for us in our business, our primary domain is .com. So I think I might actually, I'll underscore that, right? That's our primary domain is .com. Now, if you have an additional domain and you have that configured as an alias domain, let's say .com.au is an alias domain, what that's going to do is any email sent to .com.au, it's going to actually automatically forward them to the equivalent .coms. So let's say, for example, we got a couple of users in there and, you know, maybe we've got, you know, Peter at, maybe we've got, you know, Regina at, they're all using the .com, but basically, because we also have .com.au set up as an alias, any .com.au is basically going to automatically forward into those mailboxes, right? That's how an alias domain works. Now, an add-on domain basically means that we can have some other users and they can use a secondary domain as their primary login. So maybe it's Scott at yourdomain.com.au. He can use that to log in. And so you're going to have additional users that have a secondary domain as their primary domain. Now, the easiest way to think about this is to think about these as buckets of email. And so when someone sends you an email, you're going to have a bucket. So emails are going to come in to these individual buckets of email. And so you can have different domains. Now, this is called, in this case, an add-on domain, right? So .com.au becomes your add-on domain. You have your primary domain, and then you also have your secondary or your add-on domain. Now, you can have as many add-on domains as you like. I'm sure there's a limit, probably 30 or 40 or 50, but effectively it allows you to manage multiple brands or multiple buckets. Now, the question here that is being asked is, I have an alias domain right now, but I want to turn that into a secondary domain, or basically turn that into a add-on domain. So this person has what is right now an alias domain. They're forwarding everything into there, and all the users basically sit on the separate one. But what they're asking is, can I convert this into an add-on domain? Well, right now, if everything is in an alias, so Scott's sitting over here on the left-hand side. And what this person is asking is, well, can I move Scotty over to here? Yes, you can, but it's important that you do this quickly, basically. What the process is going to look like is, if right now you have each one of these connected and you go into your admin panel and you say, okay, well, for now, I want to no longer make that domain an alias domain. For you to convert that from an alias into an add-on domain, you actually have to completely remove the domain from your admin panel. And the moment that you do that, emails are going to stop flowing to that domain. So Scott is going to go from scott.com.au working to just being scott@yourdomain.com. And so the moment that that happens, your customers will probably start receiving bounce backs if they try and email those email addresses. And until you reconfigure the domain again, you're not going to receive any email to that secondary domain. So it's not a trouble. You just want to make sure that you do this process out of business hours. Very quickly, we're going to go back and we're going to set up .com.au as an add-on domain. And then the last step in that is we're going to take Scott and we're going to rename his user, and we're going to actually then move that under .com.au. That's conceptually what we're working on here. Let me show you what that actually looks like inside an administrator user panel, because this is a pretty important one to get right. So I'm going to go to my admin panel. It's admin.google.com. And let's go ahead and log in. Now, of course, you need to be a super administrator to manage any of your domains, account and then domains. And we're going to manage our domains. Okay, so you can see here that I've got our primary domain, itgenius.com. And you'll remember that's basically the bucket of email that we have on the left there. And I have a number of additional domains here. So I have a secondary domain here. So this is basically my, what was called an add-on domain, added as a secondary domain. And then I have a number of alias domains as well. So itgenius.asia, itgenius.com.au are both configured as aliases. Now, if I wanted to convert one of these aliases to a second domain or an add-on domain, what I would have to do would be to first remove that. I'm not going to do it in our little demo, but that's going to remove it. And then I can go back to immediately re-add it and then add it straight back on here. Now, if you're lucky, Google won't actually ask you to re-verify that domain again. Usually when you add a new domain for the first time, you've got to do a DNS verification. You've got to, you know, put in some different codes in your DNS, text files and, you know, CNAME files to actually verify that you own the domain. If you're lucky, Google won't ask you to redo that. But either way, I would recommend that you do this process outside of business hours at your least busy times. And what that means is, just in case anything goes wrong, you don't actually get stuck by taking your emails offline for your staff, because they're going to get annoyed and your customers are going to get annoyed as well. Now, the last step in this process is to actually realign the users, because remember, we said that Scott initially was over here on the left-hand side and we had to move Scott and rename his account. Well, you're just going to go ahead and do that in the user accounts. So inside my user accounts, if I go ahead and open up, let's maybe open up Peter and give you a bit of a rundown on how we do this. Now, if I want to change users between primary domains, there's a bit of a method to making sure that you get this perfect. And we've got other videos on the risks and some of the things you've got to watch out for if you're moving users between different domains. But you can see here that under my account, I have alternative email addresses. Now, if I choose to rename this user, any add-on or secondary domains I have, the UK one is not yet verified, so it doesn't show up here, but I can actually select from a drop-down and change my primary domain for this user. So we would be doing that for Scott. We'd be changing Scott's primary domain, and that would allow us to have him see the new emails from his new email bucket, and he would be able to sign in with his new scott@itgenius.com.au emails. Any questions about that, let me know down below in the comments, and I'll be glad to cover them for you. If you like this content, please hit subscribe and hit the bell notification so you can be notified when we go live or drop new content on the channel. Now, if you'd like to connect with us, hit us up on social media or join our free community group. All the links to that are right below this video. If you'd like to learn more about Google Workspace and the technology ecosystem, you can join our free Genius Academy by transferring your billing across to IT Genius, or you can join a Workspace Basics Bootcamp. Now, if you're a business owner and you're interested in an audit on your technology stack or your Workspace account, or you're looking to do a project in the tech world, well, you can take advantage of our free consultation. And if you need help right now, then consider joining Concierge or taking up a quick fix with our team for professional support for your tech stack.